What's up, guys? In our recent video, we looked at how to install QGIS plugins using the plugins menu in QGIS. So today we are going to look at the second method of how to install QGIS, and this can be done using the downloading the plugin. So we're just going to jump into it, and the first step would be to navigate to the plugins.qgis.org website, and then this is where we have the plugins, and you can identify the plugin that you want to work with. And today I identified one of the plugins in the plugin repository, a plugin called QR barcode layout item. And when you go to the plugin, you can just click on the download latest. You can also check on the details for the plugins, the author, maintainer, tags, the plugin homepage, if there is, and the tracker, and the latest stable version. And you can also check on the version numbers. So I've already downloaded this plugin. Otherwise, if you are to download, you'll just click on the download latest button. So after downloading it, I have saved it in my desktop. So it is the plugins normally come as a zipped file, or as a zipped in a zipped format file. So this is how it looks like. So the first thing we are going to do, we are going to extract. You're going to extract. So it is extracting to a fold into its folder. So this is how it looks like. So we need to, QGIS has, when you download plugins, it usually stores its plugins in the a folder called plugins. It is inside the app data folder. That is if you're using Windows. So the quickest way to access this app data folder, you can just click on the start, and then you type run, and then when you click run, actually it has appeared here. There is this variable that starts with a percent, then app data, then percent. So this means that this is a variable, or something called an environmental variable, but you're not going to get into the details. So then you click OK. When you click OK, it opens this app data roaming, and then inside this we have QGIS folder, and then inside QGIS we have the QGIS 3 folder, and then inside it we have profiles. So you can inside the profiles you have the default profile. Otherwise, if you have created new profiles in QGIS, which is something that we're also not going to look at, it's out of the scope of this video, then so you'll use the default. Inside the default now we have this related files, and as you can see you have something like related quick map services and all that. Then we have Python. Inside the Python we have a folder that is return plugins, that is named plugins. So this is where we are going to just copy or paste our item. So I'm just going to drag and drop it here, and then after we do that, just to be certain, this is the path. So inside the drive C users, the user, inside the user there's a folder called app data. It's normally hidden unless you have hidden it, or you have decided to put it not hidden. Then inside it we have roaming, and then we have QGIS, QGIS 3, profiles, default, Python, and then plugins. So it's quite a long path. But nevertheless, this is the path that QGIS uses. So what I'm going to do, my QGIS is running, so I'm just going to close it, and then I'm going to open it again. Yeah, well, it's opening, you can see if those plugins have appeared. So we have these inside the plugins menu that we had checked in our previous video. We will click manage and install plugins. Then after fetching, you'll notice that it has appeared. Yeah, so you can download the plugin manually or copy it from somewhere in a zip and then extract it and then copy it in the folder for QGIS plugin. So this is a plugin that we have just installed. As you can see, these are some of the details. You have the author, then you have the installed version and all this information and what the plugin does. So we are just going to close. And this particular plugin, its work is, let me just open it again. This plugin, the work of this plugin is adding QR and linear barcode items into the QGIS print layout. So I'll just close this, and the print layout is it's normally used to print the map output. So I'll just create an empty layout, and I'll just call it layout one, and I click OK. So this is a layout that is used to print the map, to generate or to design your map. So I'll just navigate to add item. There's this QR barcode item, but you can add a linear barcode, and then you notice that the cursor has changed into a plus. And then once I've drawn this box, you notice that we have a linear barcode. And then similarly, we can also add a QR code. So I can also drag and drop some QR code there. And so we have these two, and they're also being shown here. So basically, this is what it does. Yeah, and you can check the properties for each item. So I've not explored the plugin in depth, but maybe you can check on how it works. So yeah, so that is how the plugin looks like, and that's how it is. Yeah, so you can explore more on the plugin, but basically that is how we install. That's how we install the plugin manually, so to speak. So in our next video, we'll check on one or two plugins that are come in handy while using QGIS.